Hello, my name is Gabby, and welcome to my show, 1738. I'm interviewing famous movie star Allison. What kind of movies do you like, Allison?
I honestly like romantic comedies. That sounds really lame. And some mystery movies, you know, so it can kind of keep you suspenseful. It can keep you on the edge of the seat to see what's going to happen next.
I like rom-coms too.
Yeah.
All right.
They're good.
So what is your favorite movie?
That is a tough question. My favorite movie would probably have to be, it's between Grease, Hairspray, and the Titanic.
Ah, so like all classical kind of
movies. Yeah, like and musical kind of stuff. Yeah.
High School Musical?
No. Not that one.
All right. So what's in it that you like about your favorite movie? Or movies?
I'll pick the Titanic. The Titanic, I love that one because it's like so, it's like a cute romantic story, but it also keeps you at the edge of your seat, you know? So it's like you want to know what's going to happen next. You want to know who's going to die or who's going to live, you know?
They all die.
On a positive note, yeah. Well, no, not all.
Most of them. All right, so what is your favorite genre of movie? And what about it? Do you like?
Probably my favorite genre of movie would be, I guess, I like musicals, so like Hairspray or Grease.
Grease. Maybe my top. Mm-hmm. What movies do you like to take part in?
My favorite movie to act in, my favorite kind of movie, would probably have to be comedy movies.
Comedy movies?
Mm-hmm, because it's fun seeing everyone laugh and hearing the reactions from everyone. So
have you ever had a part that you didn't like?
No, not yet.
Not yet.
Maybe in the future, but not yet.
Hopefully not. So who's your favorite actress or actor?
My favorite actor, I'd have to say Zac Efron.
Oh God, High School Musical.
Besides High School Musical and like Hairspray and stuff, and he's just been with us through so much. High School Musical is one of those things. You know, Hairspray, and he was in a Nicholas Sparks movie as well, so he's probably my fave. So,
very fit.
HMU Zac Efron, if you're out there.
So how much do you get paid?
It varies. It can be $1 million a year and $2 million a year. Sometimes
wow.
$2 billion.
Oh my God.
If it's a good movie.
Sharing is caring.
Sounds good.
So, what are you working on now?
Right now, my fellow cast and I are working on a very historic themed movie, and it's very sad.
Very sad?
It's very sad.
Why so?
So bring a box of tissues when you see it.
Oh.
Yeah. It'll touch you.
So what do you do to unwind every day after? Like, you do everything and you're tired and...
Netflix and chill. Basically.
Do you watch your own movies when you Netflix and chill?
Sometimes. I'm not going to lie. Sometimes. Who doesn't? But, yeah.
So thank you for your time, and thank you, Allison.
Thank you so much for having me. Oh, 1 minute. So you were asking me about my favorite movies. How about, what kind of movies do you like? What kind of things do you enjoy watching?
I like sad movies, honestly. But
it gets to your feelings, doesn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, my favorite is Juno, though.
That one is
top.
I watched 5 minutes of it, and I was scared to finish the rest.
No, it's like, pretty good.
Yeah.
It's pretty good.
Yeah.
She's very pregnant.
Ratings. Yeah.
Very
that
pregnant.
That is very true. I saw the commercials.
Very, very pregnant.
Extremely.
All right, so thank you again, and I liked having you here. Maybe we'll have you later.
Thank you so much. Sounds good.
Welcome to the Donovan Show. Today we have a famous comedian named Kayla Springs. I am your host, Donovan Beals, so let's get started. Have you ever met Chuck Norris?
I have. Great person.
Who do you think is better, Bruce Lee or Chuck Norris?
Definitely Bruce Lee.
Why do you say that?
Because he does all this karate moves and it's just like, gets you down real quick. It's great.
So, anybody in the world, who do you think inspires you the most?
I would have to say my mom.
Do you have any family members that are comedians as yourself?
I do. My cousin is one, and he's pretty great at it.
How much do you get paid per, like, act or shoot?
Well, every show is about
$50,000. $50,000.
So, you know.
I wish I got paid that much.
Oh, yeah, that's great.
How was being a comedian in a different country?
It's hard because sometimes they don't understand you and you kind of got to go slower.
Do you pull from life experiences to create materials?
I do. I feel like it's kind of easier to pull what you experience to comedy.
How does it feel when the audience doesn't laugh or goes the way you planned it to be?
Well, usually people laugh at when you, like, hurt yourself. So, you know, kind of fake fall or, yeah.
Has anyone, like, ever just, like, try to steal your material or your
act?
Oh,
yeah. Oh, yeah. It happens all the time.
How did that make you feel?
Kind of upset because I would never do it to them.
Who do you like better, Chris Rock or Nick Swanson?
Chris Rock.
Where do you go on tours to, like, different countries?
Mostly stay around United Kingdom type places.
What's the most, like, biggest audience that you've ever performed in front of?
Around 30,000 people, just about.
What type of comedy do you find most funny, verbal, physical, or mental?
Verbal.
How did you get started to become a comedian?
Well, everyone always said I was funny. I'm like, I should go do something about it. So I did.
Which do you enjoy performing more, stand-ups or movies?
Movies.
Would you say Adam Sandler is one of the greats?
I would say he is.
Do you ever think you would be as good as him?
I hope so.
Do you make fun of others the way other comedians' friends make fun of you?
Yes.
Do you have a plan for when you retire?
Not really. Kind of going with the flow.
It is clear that you have had an awesome time here. Will you ever come back?
I definitely would. I enjoy it.
Do you have any, like, jokes you would like to tell me?
No.
All right, well, thank you for all for watching. I thought to leave you with, don't you just think it's weird how Jackie Chan's son died the same the way he did? Goodbye.
I think that's pretty weird.
You think it's weird?
I think it's weird.
All right. Well, thanks for having you on the show. Follow me on IG, TWL Flame.
Hi there. My name is Evan Swartz. Welcome to my show. So today I have a very special guest with me. Say hi, Chris Brown.
Hello.
So Chris Brown, is it true that you just wrote a new song?
Yes, in fact it is. It's called I'm White Now.
That That's great. I'm not laughing at you. I'm laughing at these beautiful flowers.
Yes.
They are very laughable, aren't they? Ah, I love flowers. Now, back to your new song. What is it called? Now, I'm White Now.
I'm White Now. It's a very philosophical song. So you have to kind of go behind the words, get the meaning.
That's really good. I'm sorry, these flowers are beautiful. I'm gonna put them in front of your face so I can see the flowers more. So now, if I'm being told right, you are white now.
Yes, I am. And I wrote my song about that.
I thought you wrote that song about this plant because it's kind of white. I'm a little colorblind. Am I colorblind? I feel like blood is dripping from my eyes. Is that, you know, I have no butt. Some people may refer to me as a mermaid or a merman.
These flowers are so cheerful.
They are very cheerful. I don't know what happened to my butt. It just walked off one day. Now, Chris Brown, why are you white now?
Well, I went to sleep one night and I woke up and I was a little white boy.
That is beautiful. Wow, that is beautiful. That is very beautiful. You know, sometimes I wish I was white, but I can't tell because I'm colorblind. I kind of feel a little gray today and a little blue, a little pink, a little sad. But that's okay because I know deep down, I don't know what I am. But remember, just because you look weird doesn't mean you are weird. Now, on to more pressing matters. Is it true that you beat your wife with a spatula today?
No, actually, it was a spatula tied to a snail shell.
Hmm. Yes, and what kind of snail was it? Was it escargot? Did you go in your car and go to the local S restaurant to pick up a shell and beat your wife?
No, I went deep sea diving.
Wow. Deep sea diving, huh? You know, I went deep sea diving once. I died. And look at me now. I don't have a butt. Now, other matters may include that. What do you think about Rihanna and Kim Kardashian? If they were to have a fight together with bears, who do you think would win?
I think the bears would, sir.
These plants are so funny. This one's waving at me. Hi, little plant. How are you doing? So, other things that, so, we live a bit. As I was saying, why did you beat your wife? Was she just ugly?
Well, she stole the hamburger I was going to eat.
What kind of hamburger was it? Was it plain or was it cheese?
It was a cheese and buffalo burger.
Wow, I wish I could have a burger, but look at me now, I can't even get up. This chair is so comfy. It's finally upholstered. Hey, Chris Brown.
Yes?
This plant's so funny. As I was saying, Chris Brown, will you trade me your golden albums for this chair I found? It's finally upholstered. I'll even give you a Cadbury cream egg, which is worth about $2. You'll also have to pay that price.
I will consider it. That chair is very nice.
You also have a chair too. You know, I might just give you two chairs.
Yes, I'd like to get up and look at it.
Can you hit that whip, Chris Brown?
I cannot get up. I cannot hit a whip if I'm sitting down.
Can you move your arm? Just do this.
No, my elbows are also stuck to the chair. I can't move.
I'm sorry, Chris Brown. Looks like you'll be stuck here for a while. All right, well, thank you for tuning into my show where I talk about crap I don't know of. So, thank you again for tuning in. Now, Chris Brown, one more thing. Bears or sharks?
Sharks.
You heard it here.
Now, excuse me, I'm going to try and leave.
Thank you, come again.
Hello, my name is Allie, and you're watching my show. Today we have Donovan on the show today. I've always wanted to find out more about you. I'm super excited that you're here, so let's get started. What or who inspired you to start music business?
Well, my dad is Eminem, so you feel me? I just really like music, so I just wanted to start the industry.
Who is your favorite artist to listen to?
My favorite artist to listen to? Probably me and my dad. He talks about our life and how we went through the struggle, and it inspires me to rap about other things and listen to other people's struggles.
What type of music do you like?
I like R&B music, and I like rap, but I don't like really like hardcore rap with all the cussing and stuff in it. It's not for me.
How is life being married to another celebrity?
It's cool. Sometimes she acts like a thot, though, so can't really help that.
Is it hard to raise a child in the spotlight?
Sometimes we gotta run from the paparazzi and stuff outside of the house. But other than that, it's pretty cool having attention all the time. Feel me?
Do you write your own music?
Sometimes. And if I'm just bored and I wanna make a single or something, I'd pay some one of these little artists to make me a song and I record it.
How long does it usually take to record a song?
Sometimes it can take days, sometimes it can take hours. Just depends on how you're feeling that day.
Tell me about life while you're on a tour.
Life on a tour. You know, we turn up because that's what you gotta do. And then you get to meet new fans, like people. It's pretty cool.
How do people find out about your music?
I have this person online who always like makes advertisements about me, and it gets through the internet real quick. You put it on Instagram, Snapchat, and all that, and it just gets viral.
Has there ever been any crazy audience members at your show?
Yeah, concert? One time when me and my little co-person, he was on the stage and somebody threw a shoe at him. He got injured, broke his leg because he had tried to dodge and he moved and messed it up.
What do you do in your free time?
My free time, since I'm always working, most of the time I'm with my kids or I'm just at the house sleeping.
What is it like having your life in the spotlight?
It's cool sometimes, but I'm not really a on the radar type of person. So I kind of like being by myself or with my family. That's about it.
Do you listen to your own music? If so, what is one of your favorite songs to hear?
One of my favorite songs to hear is whenever I featured one of Eminem's songs called Drop the World.
What do you listen to when you're in the car singing?
I like to listen to a lot of like R&B music because it's like it makes me sensational and it gets me in the mood, and it's not so hardcore, it doesn't hurt my head.
Were you ever in a group?
Nah, I like to stay by myself because other people try to steal your lyrics and your flow and all that. I'd rather just stick to myself.
What's coming up next for you?
I'm probably going to drop a new album called Hillwood Turn Up 2. It's going to be hard. Come out October next year.
Are you going on tour soon?
It all depends on how my manager works all the new ones out. We're trying to go to Italy, probably Europe, and most likely Canada.
Who's coming with you on tour?
I bring some of the little underground rappers, try to bring them on up in this world. I probably bring my dad, Eminem. That's about it.
Are there any questions you'd like to ask me?
Do you like doing this, like interviewing people?
Yeah.
Pretty cool.
Mm-hmm. Are there any more?
No, that's about it.
So what kind of movies do you like?
Type of movies? I like action movies. I like really good comedy movies. Like Adam Sandler, he's one of my favorite people.
And this concludes today's show. I am Allie, and thank you for watching.
Hi there, and thank you for watching The Allison Show. Today with me, I have Wayne. Wayne, what is your favorite movie?
Well, I can't say a favorite. I have a lot of them, but one of them could be Pirates of the Caribbean or Harry Potter, movies like those.
And what stands out to you about Harry Potter? Because I know that that's a it's an interesting series of stories. What stands out to you about those stories?
Well, you start off with the boy living under the stairs, and then growing up, going to a school, and then you find out that you're a wizard. That pretty much.
That's so cool. So, what would you say is your favorite thing to do when you're outside of school? Like, what's your favorite hobby?
Adventuring, going to places, traveling, and lots of stuff.
That's really fun.
Yeah.
Yeah, where's your favorite place to go on an adventure? Or to discover, like a cool place?
Different parts of where I live, like Nashville, going to the east or west, north, south, traveling on foot.
You don't ride a bike or drive, you just like walk all over the place?
Sometimes I like ride the bus or walk.
That is so cool. That takes a lot of willpower because I would rather drive than walk, so that's awesome. So what is your favorite food?
Pizza.
Pizza.
Or pizza or burritos, tacos.
Mm-hmm. Like Taco Bell?
Food?
Yeah. My favorite food would probably have to be, my favorite kind of food is Italian food. So like raviolis or pasta or anything, and pizza.
Pizza.
I guess too, yeah. So Wayne, tell me a little bit about growing up. Like, what school did you go to? I mean, we're still growing up, but like, you know, elementary school, middle school, where did you go?
I went to a lot of elementary schools, but one of them was like Alex Green Elementary School. And my middle schools, I went to multiple middle schools too. Mm-hmm. First, I went to Jolton, and then John Early, then Magnet Middle School. And then my last high school was Stratford, and now I'm at Hillwood.
So you've moved around a lot.
Yes, ma'am.
What would you say is your favorite school that you've been to out of all of them?
Between Hillwood? Stratford and Hillwood.
Yeah. Go Toffers. Just kidding. So what would you say was the funniest moment that you've ever lived through?
I really haven't had one yet. Still
really?
Waiting.
No embarrassing moments or anything? Or like, I wish I could take that back. That was really embarrassing.
Not so far. Not super. Not yet.
How about one of the scariest moments you've lived through?
That car accident that happened in 2012.
Car accidents are really scary. Hence
I thought I was going to die.
Hot knee brace that I have. So, where were you born originally? Where are you from?
Jackson, Tennessee.
Cool. And how far is that from here, like from Nashville?
I can't say. All I know is my mom lived there once.
Your mom lived there once. That's pretty cool. So, I heard Jackson is really cool. I heard it's kind of out past Nashville. Is that true? Is it kind of more of like a, it's not like a big, big city like Nashville, correct? It's like more of a...
I guess. I mean, I haven't been there. I was just, my mom was originally there, but I wasn't. And if I had to say where I was born, like, I would be born in like Tennessee, the original Tennessee, like here. This Nashville.
Yeah, so it's like your hometown. You'd consider that your hometown?
But
it's pretty cool.
Yeah, where were you born?
I am from Syracuse, New York, and we moved to Nashville like 10 years, a little over 10 years ago, probably. So, actually, no, I was like two, so like 13 years ago.
13 years ago.
So, yeah. What would you say is your favorite TV show? What do you like to watch?
Like some kind of sport that involves like flipping and climbing stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Parkour.
Parkour, that's really cool. I could never do any of that. Well, Wayne, thank you so much for coming onto my show. I enjoyed talking to you.
Thank you.
Oh, hi. Thank you again for tuning in to Sold Out, where me and my guest today, Noah, will now be talking about some of the newest items that are on sale. Today we will be starting out with this limited edition Star Wars battle rifle that there are only two ever made, and only one of them has been used by George Lucas. Now, we do not know if this one has been used by, it's gone. It has been sold out. You could just go, no, okay, that works. We have completely sold out of them. But don't worry, we have other offers as well. We have three Nintendo DS, We have three Nintendo DS cartridges that include Animal Crossing, Pokemon Omega Ruby, and Monster Hunter 4 Ultimate. They're gone. Sold out. But don't fret, because if you call now, you could reserve for our next product. Just call 999999999999. :9. Now, Noah, what is this?
It looks like a boombox.
Now, I'm not as young as I used to be, but I do know that this boombox is for iPhones, and it just so happens we have an iPhone with us. Now, I could put it in, it's gone. We're sold out of iPhones. This is an iPhone 4, sold out. But don't worry, if you called 777, then you could, if you call 9999999999, then you can get this limited edition boombox. It's gone. Sold out. Now, you may be thinking, why should I tune into a show where everything is sold out? Well, because we actually care about your needs. And because of that, we have another outstanding product. This chandelier was used by Queen Elizabeth. It's gone. Queen Elizabeth bought it back. Right here, we have a limited edition Nintendo 2DS with a whopping no closing. It's beautiful and very, very blue. It's gone. Sold out. Now, we've almost reached our half minute interval of our show, and because of that, we have most likely run out of products. But don't fret, because I just found a set of headphones in my pocket. They're gone. Headphones are gone. But if you did call 9999999999, don't worry, because we have one product left for you. This right here is a very deluxe chair I found. You too can have this wonderful chair. You too can have this wonderful chair by just donating $50 to our show so we could buy more stuff to sell to you. Now, Noah, what polyester do you think this is?
I think it must.
That's a great answer. Now, this chair is finely upholstered in the most common ways. It has so much nice leather that it might make you scream.
Call now and we'll sell the host. That's right, you can get a free dude.
Hi.
Oh, he's gone. Get out of here. This is my show now. All right. And it does look like we have nothing left to sell. We have this beautiful plant here. Finest of greenery you can find anywhere in the, it's already been sold. Gotta get out of here. It's just,
hi everybody, you might remember me as the guy who was just sold. Well, guess what? They wanted me to be returned, because it turns out the family who wanted me wanted a little girl. I guess love just doesn't come in small packages anymore. Now, just before I left, I just remembered my friend Noah has a limited edition, very, very limited edition, Nintendo dog tag.
This was my grandma's.
I don't care if it was your grandma's. I don't care if she died in Vietnam to fight for that thing. You're going to sell it. I'm going to get money. And we're going to make a killing.
This is my...
I don't care, Noah. But what I do care is that everybody on this show gets everything. The show has completely sold out of cash money. We are out. Out of money. Thank you for tuning in, and goodbye. I wish to see you again in my mansion.
Hi, I'm Noah, and welcome to Plant Talk. Here we have our lovely guest today. How are you doing?
I'm good. I'm pretty good today. And you?
So, plants, what's your opinion?
Plants, I like plants. I like sunflowers, any plants. Yeah.
So, how many plants do you have in your home currently?
I have like 702.
Yeah. I have 19 million.
Oh, wow.
I water each of them every day.
How long does it take you?
It doesn't take me that much time at all because I've got a system set.
What's your system?
My system is I get a bunch of pipes, get a lot of dudes.
A lot of dudes? How many dudes?
18,000 or so, you know.
How do they fit in your house?
I live in a mansion, a greenhouse mansion.
Greenhouse mansion.
By the way, my walls are made of plants. I love them so much. So, yeah. How much on average do you think you spend with your plants?
Probably like 20 hours a day. I don't even sleep. I'm just always with my plants. Always.
I talk to my plants 18 hours every minute.
Every minute?
Yes. I'm a time traveler, and I love plants.
You do? How much do you love them on a scale of 1 to 27?
18,000. I love them very, very much.
That's not even on the scale. That doesn't even count. Try again.
I thought I was the host here. Sorry, I'm just loving this plant right here. It's just so great. So anyways, what's your favorite type of plant?
I already told you, I like sunflowers.
Right. The sunflowers are great, yeah? Do you like the smell of sunflowers?
I don't think they have a smell. They smell like pollen and like allergies. They smell like allergies.
You know, I've got a room. It's only mint leaves. It smells so fabulous.
How big is the room?
Oh, it's like maybe 1,500 square feet.
That's a lot.
Yeah, I took a very long time in making that, growing the walls.
You grew the walls?
Yes. I have all the time in the world. I told you, I'm a time traveler.
That's nice. How do you time travel?
I made a time traveling machine out of plants. I discovered that plants could be used to travel through time. And I could spend even more time with them. I'm not going to specifically reveal the plants because more people would become time travelers. That would sort of interrupt the space-time continuum a little more than it needs to be. Excuse me, hello. So do you have anything else to add about your life? Like how much you spend with your plants?
No, I don't have it. I don't think so.
What is your favorite plant-related activity?
I like sleeping with my plants. I like sleep on the plants. And then I eat them after I sleep on them.
What kind of plants are your bed? Are your bed made out of? Yes.
I don't know. It's a secret. It's different plants every day.
I usually have a lamb's ears for pillow, and I have mint leaves, so I never smell bad.
So you never smell bad.
That's why I smell so strongly of mint. It permeates the entire room every time.
So you don't shower, you just sleep on mint leaves?
Yep. Sorry, I just haven't spent enough time with these today.
What are their names?
This one's Billy, and this one's Willie.
Why'd you name them Billy and Willie?
I named them after country music artists because I felt like that my estate in Tennessee would use with some aptly named plants. That would probably be great. So, how often do you eat your plants?
Like every 2 hours, actually.
It's a very healthy lifestyle, and we're about out of time. So this has been Plant Talk, here with our lovely guest. And thank you for tuning in. We will see you in the next episode of Plant Talk. Goodbye.
Hello, welcome to the Magical Creature Talk Show. My name is Wayne, and today we are having our guest, Kayla, the Queen of the Forest. So Kayla, how do you like being the queen of the forest and all?
I think being queen of the forest is the best thing ever.
So being the queen and all, do you have to make up the rules and all of that?
There aren't really any rules for the forest, but you know, whatever happens, happens.
Okay. Do you currently have a king?
No.
No?
Yep.
Okay. What was the other first laws you made when you became queen?
Well, no cutting down trees. That's a big no-no.
Why?
Because we want to preserve our forest. So that's pretty important for all the animals and whatnot.
Okay, good. Was the queen before you as loved as much as you are?
No. She got killed, so now I'm queen.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sad.
What kind of creatures do you hang out with on the weekends?
Lions and tigers and bears.
Are there only certain creatures that you allow in the kingdom, or are all welcome?
All are welcome. You know, one big happy family.
What is the hardest part about being queen?
Making sure everything's okay 24/7. That's a job right there. Yep.
Okay, have you ever gone to war with other kingdoms?
That's mostly all I do. Working with all the kingdoms and whatnot.
Do you have a big castle?
No. It's like a cabin type thing. It's small.
Small.
Yeah. Little.
Tell me about where you live.
Well, I live in the forest in a cabin, and animals come all the time. We have conversations because I can talk to animals, because being queen lets you do that.
Right.
So I have a lot of friends in the forest.
Right, okay. Right. Why do you like that?
Just communicating with different species is great. You never know what you'll tell them.
Amazing, isn't it?
So amazing.
Okay, what are some of your big plans moving forward as the kingdom grows?
Well, a bigger castle, right?
Right,
Maybe bring in more animals, you never know.
More animals?
Yep.
Okay. Do you see having kids later on in life?
No.
Do you want to have boys or girls?
No.
Why not?
I don't like kids. I prefer animals.
Oh.
You know, being queen, it's a hard job.
Okay. So how many creatures do you have in your kingdom?
Hundreds of thousands. Yep, it's pretty big.
Well, can you name some of the creatures?
Well, there's snakes, lions, tigers, bears.
Okay.
Hamsters.
Well, that's all we have today, and I would like to thank you for being on my show.
Thank you.
See you next time.
Hello, I'm Noah, and welcome to Space Talk.
So, we're here with our astronaut today, Allie. Tell me a little bit about yourself.
Well, I've accomplished many things in space. I've learned about, like, life outside of our planet and stuff.
Like, what kind of life is outside of our planet, and how far did you go?
People like us, except it was in a different galaxy.
What was the galaxy made out of?
Lots of stars, and twice as many planets as ours.
What was our galaxy made out of?
Stars and less planets.
You lied to me, Mom. It's not made out of milk. Anyway, so how far outside our galaxy have you traveled to date?
To farthest I've traveled was the end of the nearest galaxy.
It's pretty impressive, even for then. So, in the farthest planet, what was there? Was it worth a trip?
Yes, there was many really tall trees and old plants and like dinosaurs and stuff.
Well, we do know how much we love plants here on this
and
show.
Giant blue people.
Anyway, so segueing on with the term, like the galaxy composition, have you seen any other galaxies or find out what they were made of?
No. But soon there's going to be a mission for that. The rest of the information is confidential, but...
Government. What kind of training did you have to go through to be an astronaut? I know you were in the Air Force, definitely.
Yeah, we had to go on these airplane rides where they go up and down, and then we'd feel the free fall, like going up and down like hills and stuff.
It's a very strange concept.
And then also we had to sit in this chair we were strapped down in, and it would spin us and roll us around.
I
almost threw up on that ride.
So, what are your thoughts on Pluto? Like, when it became no longer a planet?
In my opinion, it's still a planet because it's, even though it's really close to the end of our galaxy, it's still a planet. Not like a little planet, it's still a planet.
I agree. Have you ever been on Pluto?
Yes. That was in the beginning of my career.
So, What's the most difficult thing you have to do on your spaceship every day?
The most difficult thing would have to be, like, getting down to places further down in the spaceship because of the gravity. Like, there's no gravity, and you pretty much have to use all your upper body to get down.
It'd be quite a workout every morning, huh?
Yeah.
Have you seen any of the relics from the Star Wars age?
No.
I'm not talking about the movies either.
No.
Huh. Excuse me just 1 second. Yeah, she hasn't seen anything from there. Anyway, never mind that. That was nothing. So, have you seen any extraterrestrial life?
Yes. They're really tall blue people.
Huh. Well, we're about out of time. Thank you very much for coming on the show. I'm Noah, and this is Space Talk.
Thanks for watching. Hi, I'm Katie, and welcome to Talking on the High Seas. Today we have a famous pirate here with us. Tell us your name, pirate.
I'm Pirate Allison.
Pirate Allison. Well, thank you for being here.
Thank you for having me.
So how long have you been a pirate?
I was probably 2 when I got the pirate spell.
Oh, wow.
Mm-hmm.
I bet that was exciting.
It was very exciting.
Now, were your parents pirates?
My dad was, but my mom wasn't. My dad is Captain Hook, you know, from the Peter Pan movies.
Oh, so yeah. Very famous. Mm-hmm. Excellent. And so what would you say a typical day is like on the high seas?
Typical day on the high seas would probably just involve, like, they're swimming, you know, since they're in the ocean. We swim a lot, and we just look for people to rob.
Okay. So tell me about the coolest treasure that you've ever discovered.
I'd say the coolest treasure I've ever discovered is probably we were scuba diving and we found a sunken ship, and when we like opened the sunken ship, we found like this really, really, really pretty necklace.
Mm-hmm.
And I got to keep it, and it was really nice.
Cool. Now, are your parents on the ship with you? Or do you have your own ship now?
I have my own ship now.
Oh, and so you have crew under you?
Yes.
Awesome. All right, so do you have to go through any training? Like, I know you got the pirate spell, but mm-hmm. was there any training that you went through?
I had a little bit of help from my dad, Captain Hook, because you know how he's like a professional.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, he just kind of taught me how to rob people correctly and you know how to find cool treasure.
Okay.
So yeah.
Excellent. And so what do you think about the Hollywood versions of pirates, like Jack Sparrow and well, how they portray Captain Hook in movies?
I think it's a smidge inaccurate because, I mean, like the Pirates of the Caribbean,
mm-hmm.
you know, Captain Jack Sparrow, his makeup isn't that good and mine always is looking nice.
Sure.
And besides that, it's a little bit off, I would say.
Do you think that pirates in real life drink as much rum as Jack Sparrow drank in those movies?
Some do. Some probably do. Sure. I drink sparkling grape juice.
Oh, nice.
Mm-hmm.
A little classier than rum on the beach. Awesome.
For sure.
So tell me about your ship. Is it like? Do you have a really big ship? What kind of flags are flying? And
it's a pretty big ship. I have a flag with the island's, you know, it's like the island flag.
Nice.
And it has a palm tree on it, and it's really pretty because, you know, we're at the beach. And
so now most people retire. When they retire, they go live at the beach.
Mm-hmm.
Where does a pirate go when they retire?
to, like, log cabins, like the Smoky Mountains or something. Uh-huh. You know, it's a totally different environment than...
Yeah.
And the sea is for such a long time.
Do you think you'll give up the robbing of people when you retire?
Yes, it's like a bonus for being a pirate, you know?
Cool. Yeah. Now, these treasures that you find, do you find them on other ships or do you go in like caves and find them? Like where would one find hidden treasure?
It really depends. Sometimes if you find like a sunken ship and it looks like it was a nice quality sunken ship, and that's mm-hmm. when you can find pretty nice treasure. And then in caves, you know, it's like usually a lot older, so it's more valuable.
Gotcha. So I've always been told that either an eye patch or a peg leg or, you know, a bird on your shoulder is required mm-hmm. to be a pirate, but I have none of those things. Could I become a pirate?
Yes.
Oh, I could.
Yeah.
So peg leg not required.
Mm-mm.
That
there's
is
also there's a pirate a degree in being a pirate
uh-huh.
that you can get too, which also helps.
Oh.
And yeah.
Cool. So what do you eat on the ship? Do you cook there or do you actually like come to the land and eat at, you know, TGI Fridays or something?
If it's a really good fun day, then we'll go to the land and eat at our favorite restaurants. And if it's kinda like just a slow day, then we'll just stay, you know, on the ship and catch our food.
So, like, what does a pirate do for downtime? How do you relax?
Pirates usually relax by just kind of unwinding and, like, they lie down and we watch TV. And
so do you get Wi-Fi on your ship?
Yes.
Excellent.
That was a must.
Very important.
Yeah.
Very important. All right, well, thank you so much for being here. We hope that you'll come back, and I hope I get to visit your ship sometime. And thank you for watching.
Thank you so much.
Thanks.
Hello, I'm Noah, and welcome to Video Game Talk. Here today we have Ezio from Assassin's Creed. How you doing, man?
Okay.
Sorry, we had to disarm you before you came in, so...
It's good.
Alright. So, what's life like as a member of the Assassins?
Well, as a parkourist, it's pretty okay. Killing people, I don't know why, because it's been a long time since I've been doing so, but it's okay what I do. Mm-hmm. Roaming the streets, taking innocents' lives. Okay.
Very cheerful. Anyway, so what else do you do? Do you do any, are you a good Samaritan?
Yeah. In fact, I am.
What was the last good thing you did?
I killed the person that tried to take over a whole state.
All right.
And end the world.
It's very heroic. Anyway, so how many people have you hit with a mace so far? Do you know?
Not that I can think of. Too many fools that I've killed today.
So, segueing on, how many Templars have you killed?
Like I said, too many fools I've killed today. Not sure.
So, atop of your blades, which we had to disarm from you, what are the other tools of an assassin?
Well, a dagger, a gun, tomahawk, throwing knives, a part of the blade, hidden blade, poison part, and if money counts as a weapon, because it comes with an extraction, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Can you throw money at someone and knock them off, like a bridge or something? Because that would be...
No. What you do with the money is you throw it into the crowd. The crowd comes around, then it makes it easy for me to escape because it's a big distraction. Huh. With the people around me.
It's very, very clever.
I know.
How often do you have to run?
Pretty much all the time when I'm on the roofs. Or free running. I have to run all the time to get to places. It just depends on the rush I'm in.
See. So most of our audience today are Templars because they want to come and they wanted to come and kill you. This was not intended. I'm sorry.
So what?
Right. And so now that we've got all of this gotten down out of the way, do you often travel to other places? Do you have any exotic locales?
Florence. That's where I came from. That's where I was living until my brothers and dad were killed. Then I became assassin.
How did you find your way here into the States?
My uncle Mario.
Great man.
He trained me into a skilled assassin. He's an assassin too.
I never would have guessed.
Well, you do know me.
Well, it seems that we're about out of time. So, thank you very much for being on the show, Mr. Ezio. Alright. If you're sitting, won't let go of my hand. It'll be a nice day. Goodbye.
Welcome to my show. It's the stupid con, whatever it is. Say we have.
This is a sitcom.
Right, sir.
So welcome back to Real Talk with us. What's up? I'm Evan. That's Wayne. Say hi, Wayne.
Hi.
I didn't ask you, Wayne. I asked the other Wayne. Say hi, Wayne. Good, Wayne. Now, if I'm aware, the new Metal Gear just came out. Am I correct?
Correct. You are a guest.
Now, because the new Metal Gear is out, what features do you think it'll come with the new with the series? This could be the last of Hideo Kojima's work. Did I say that right?
I should have probably asked you that.
Well, how about you ask me that and we'll cut that out. So go ahead and ask me that question.
How's your day today?
I'm doing fine, actually. I really just want to go home and play Fallout New Vegas. That's not going to happen because I'm going on a camping trip. Yay.
What do you feel about this lamp right here?
Well, this lamp, it looks like it's been bruised, shot, and spat on. That's why I put it over here, and I'm pushing it very close towards you.
Right, well,
how do you feel about my new Jordans I got today? Look at these. There's a big J on them.
Whoa.
Yeah,
look at those.
Look at these Jordans. They're pretty impressive. I bought them
for
$2,000 at the closest Tiger Mart.
$2,000?
$2,000, man. Really
That's
impressive.
That's a lot.
I know. A lot of big money.
Well, can I get me some of those?
I don't think you can.
Why? Because they're not fashionable?
No, because they only look good on me.
Good point.
Laugh track. Anyway, I was thinking, what are those? What are those?
They're Russian boots. Got a problem with them?
Yeah, mine are better than those.
Those aren't boots. You can't call those boots.
Everything's better than Jordan. The Jordans are better than anything. Make sure no one hears that. Anyway.
Okay, well, if you weren't coming here today, what would you be doing?
I would probably be at home playing Oblivion on my PlayStation 3 while I'm at Burger King drinking a Sprite. I didn't mean to say I would be at Burger King. What I meant to say was I'd be eating at Burger King. No, that didn't come out right either. Hey, guess what?
What?
What are those?
Again, they're Russian boots. Got a problem.
Awesome. I really wanted to know what those were. Thank you for clarifying that for me. Are you gonna ask me what are these? They're
no.
J's. Jordans.
I know what
That's
those
what the
are.
J stands for on there. So, anyway, if I was at home right now, I'd be playing Oblivion drinking a Sprite from Burger King. You ever played Oblivion?
No, I have not.
What is it? Well, it's an Elder Scrolls game that was made in 2006. That was one of the only JRPGs out there.
Mm-hmm.
No, not a JRPG. JRPG stands for Japanese role-playing game. What I meant to say was RPG. That was not made by Squaresoft. Square Enix? How do you feel about that name change? Happened back in the 90s.
I don't know. How do you feel about the name change?
Well, I feel it's really confusing, because if I'm going to say, hey, I'm going to go play Chrono Trigger made by Squaresoft, they'll be like, oh, you mean Square Enix? Confusion. What are those?
Right, well,
now,
how old are you?
Well, currently, I am a child. I don't know if you knew that, but I'm currently a child. It's pretty obvious that I am still a teenager who has to finish whatever's left of puberty, but I'll cross that bridge when I get to it.
Right, well, got any jobs on you?
Jobs? Well, I'm 14, so I don't think I can apply for any good jobs right now.
Mm-hmm.
Or anything, or any job.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. What about you?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So, before I go, just
before
gotta ask,
go.
I gotta ask something. What are those?
What are those?
Thank you for tuning in, and goodbye.
You're students from Hillwood High School.
We just learned TV production here at NECAT.
It was so much fun.
Thank you, Ascent, for making this happen! Yeah!
Thank you! Yeah.